Hey guys, in this video, I'm gonna show you my method for finding a big list of long tail keywords that are going to be less competitive, more profitable, and easier to rank for. And then at the end of this video, I'll give you a few tips on how you can incorporate those keywords into your advertising campaigns. But first, let me show you just how important this is here. So what I've done is modified a search term report for our product, which if you're not familiar, at Jungle Scout, we sell these washable pee pads for dogs. So coming back over to our search term report here, I identified two keywords that we're doing a lot of spending on in the past 90 days. This first search term here is a very broad search term. In fact, it's our category's biggest search term at 93,000 monthly searches. So dog pee pads is really popular. And of course, we're not the only people that know this. Our competitors do as well. So that's why we're competing very aggressively for this keyword and paying almost $4 per click. Now, let's compare that to a long tail keyword like reusable puppy pads, waterproof, which in fact actually is exactly what we're selling here. Our product is reusable, it is waterproof. And as you can see here, we're only getting about 2,000 monthly searches for this keyword. However, we're only paying about $2 per click and our click-through rate is significantly higher in this very broad and competitive search term here. And to sort of show that here, I wanted to bring up two search terms. So this first one is for that dog pee pads, very broad keyword. And as we see here, the very first row of products, they are sponsored, are a mix of, we have one reusable and three different disposable pee pads for dogs. But if we go down to the first row of organic products, we'll see that these are all disposable pee pads, not reusable like the product that we're selling. And then coming down again to the highly related section, again, they're all disposable and not reusable like our product. But let's come over here to this search term here, the long tail keyword, reusable puppy pads waterproof. You'll see that these are all waterproof and reusable pee pads, just like our product. And in fact, when we scroll down, I noticed this earlier, we are the first spot here in the highly rated section. Then right next to us is a clear knockoff of our product, as you can see by the product's packaging. And I only know that because you can come down here to the date first available and you see that we launched about a year and a half before them. So good for them. But either way, what I wanted to show here is the importance of finding more long tail keywords just like this, because as you can see from the spend, we basically spent the same amount of money on both these keywords. However, our profitability and the sales that we've gotten back is significantly better on this long tail keyword because it's more relevant for our product. Now, one more thing I wanted to show you before going into the strategy or the three-step method for finding more long tail keywords is our Jungle Scout keyword rank tracker tool here. I plugged in both of these keywords, the long tail keyword as well as the broad keyword. And you can notice right away that that broad keyword organically has only shown up on the map twice. So March 29th and March 30th, we were ranked on the 24th position on page one. Whereas the long tail keyword, we've always been on the map and we've ranged from the 45th position to it looks like the top 10 at some points organically. And then if we come to the sponsored rankings here, you can see that we've actually been at the number one position pretty often for that long tail keyword. Whereas this other keyword, we did actually get to the one spot on these 2 days, but it sort of fizzled out and we never really got it before then, despite advertising on it. So this is why you wanna find more long tail keywords, because they're gonna be more profitable for you. They're gonna be less competitive and easier to rank for. So now the question is, how do you find more long tail keywords just like this one? So there's actually gonna be three reports that I'm gonna show you how to download and then combine them together so you have a really neat and organized list. Now that first report is in your brand analytics. It's the search query performance report. What this report will show you is all these top search terms that lead customers to your brand's products. And you can quickly find this under brands here and then click brand analytics and then in this search query performance tab. But what I wanna do here is I wanna do this on the ASIN level. So by clicking ASIN view, in finding my product here, I'm gonna go to the longest date range that I can find. And for that, I'll go quarterly, this past quarter, and the first quarter. And clicking apply now will give me the top keywords or search terms for this product. But what I wanna do here is expand it to the top 100 rows first. Now we'll get a bunch of keywords that we can generate a download for by clicking here, generate download. And it should bring you to a page like this. Once it downloads, you can just click download, but I already have that downloaded here. So I'll go ahead and do that right now. Okay, so this is the very first report you wanna download. It's the search query performance report, but where this report shows you the top search terms that brought traffic to your listing, this next report is gonna show you the top keywords that you brought to your listing through paid ads. And that's your search term report here. So go ahead and download a search term report here. You wanna make sure to do it for both your sponsored products, brands, and display campaigns if you have those set up. Make sure you download a search term report. pick a date range. On Amazon, they only let you go back about 65 days, I believe. So try to use the longest date range you can. However, it's really important to set up recurring reports. This is like a little ninja pro tip in here that has nothing to do with today's video, but what I like to do is set this up on a monthly recurring report and then choose a date range that is far into the future so I don't have to worry about it expiring. However, if you don't have recurring reports set up and you can only go back to the past 60 or 65 days or so, one little workaround you can do if you're a Jungle Scout user is heading over to our advertising analytics tool. Going to the third tab here, advertising performance, you can scroll down and see your keywords and search terms here for as long as you have your Jungle Scout account. So it's going to store data for way longer than what Amazon does. And just keep in mind that this tool was recently introduced to Jungle Scout last year, so it only has about a year or so of data. But again, compared to Amazon, it's far more data than you get. So I'm gonna have the past year of data pulled up here and download a CSV file this way. But again, if you don't have Jungle Scout, you can just download a search term report. But again, you have to make sure to do it for your sponsored brands, sponsored products, and sponsored display campaigns. Whereas Jungle Scout, one of the benefits is it has all of those campaigns in one report. So I can just click download here and open that up. Now this is what your search term report is gonna look like. So what we wanna do now is the last report that we did, the search query performance report, had it separated by ASIN, but on Amazon, we don't have that luxury, but this is why it's really important to have a campaign naming structure that makes it easier for you to go through Google Sheets or Excel and find the data that you're looking for. So in our case, what we can do is we can clear everything here. And because I've named all of our campaigns with the words PPADS and selecting all here would only show me campaigns and search terms that came from that product. So if you don't have a campaign naming convention like this, you could also put it in a portfolio and then using Amazon's report, you can sort by the portfolio. However, I strongly recommend having a solid campaign naming convention that makes it easier for you to sort through the data that you're looking for. Okay, now at this point, we just wanna find the search terms that we actually got sales on. So coming over to the sales column here, let's get rid of the keywords that have zero sales behind it. And now that will show us only search terms that brought us sales to our listing. And then what you could also do is come over here to the ACOS column and filter by condition and go less than or equal to your target ACOS. So maybe ours is 50, for example, put that in. And now we're just gonna see search terms that brought sales in very profitably for us. Okay, so the third and final report we wanna download is a reverse ASIN search on our top competitors. Now the reason why we wanna do this is because that first report that we downloaded only is going to show us products or keywords, sorry, that are bringing traffic to our products. And then the advertising report here is only gonna show us the search terms that we use in our advertising campaigns, but again, to just our products. So the reason why we wanna do a reverse ASIN search on our top competitors is to get their keywords into the mix as well. So what I recommend doing here is copying over at least 10 of your competitors' ASINs into a tool like Jungle Scout. And what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna shortcut this. I have a saved list already for our PPADS competitors, but go ahead and copy in at least 10 of your competitors' ASINs into a tool like this. Now, scrolling down here, you can see these are all the competitors that we're gonna be finding their keywords on. But we have about 7,000 keywords here. What I actually wanna do is come over here to these filters. And remember, we're trying to find long tail keywords. So in this word count, I'm actually gonna use 4. Feel free to use 3 or 5 or whatever number you want, but I'm gonna use 4 in this case. So only find me keywords that have at least 4 words in them. But also I wanna make sure that it has search volume. But to keep it open, I'm just gonna put 100 as the minimum there. That way, I'm curious about all the other search terms that are getting, you know, 50 searches a month, but I might not prioritize them. Now, expanding these advanced filters, a cool little trick I like to do here is come over to the organic ASINs count column. And what I wanna do is put 2 in the minimum here. And the reason why I'm doing that is because you might find a lot of keywords in this list here that are branded. And essentially what this is going to do is eliminate keywords that only one competitor is ranking for. So essentially what I'm asking Jungle Scout to do is find me keywords where at least 2 competitors are ranking for it in the top 100. But 100 is a lot. So what I actually wanna do is bring that down a little bit. Coming over here to the organic ASINs rank, I can use in the max column 50. And what that's gonna do now is show me keywords, if I scroll or zoom back out here, that have at least 4 words in them, are at least getting 100 exact monthly searches for it, 2 competitors are ranking for it, in the top 50. So we're bringing it down from 100 to 50 here. And then I can go ahead and click apply, and our list of 7,000 keywords will hopefully become a lot shorter, which we can see is now 65 keywords. Great. One thing I wanna do real quick, cool, I did notice it. If I see in this category column over here, health and household, this term is washable PPADS for adults. we're not selling adult pee pads. So what I should have done earlier is come over here to the product category and select pet supplies, which is our category. And that will eliminate a bunch of irrelevant search terms or keywords that we want to get rid of. So it's cool. We still have 72 keywords here. Now what we can do is really go through this list. We can select all and then just deselect the ones that don't make sense to us. For example, maybe, let's see, pee pad holder for dogs. You know, we're not selling a pee pad holder, but we are selling the pee pad. Clicking this icon will actually run a search term or a search for it on Amazon. And I'm curious, okay, so there are products advertising on this search term here. And I can see how this would be a keyword we wanna keep an eye on, but maybe not advertise on too much. Maybe we test it out in a few campaigns, but maybe it wouldn't work, but maybe it would. So that's a good example of really looking through your list and trying to identify irrelevant versus, you know, really high priority keywords here. So I'm just gonna keep this list for now for the sake of time and add it to a keyword list. I'm just gonna name this, long tail keywords. And specifically for our PPADS product, share it with my team and then create an ad. Now, remember, we do have these two other reports that we made earlier, the search query performance and our advertising report. What I actually wanna do now is it doesn't matter which list you start with, is copy over one set of keywords into the other file. And I'm gonna paste that in here. And then essentially, just like we did in Jungle Scout, I wanna find search terms that have at least four words. I wanna find those long tail keywords. So what I'll do here is insert a column to the left. Now, because I'm horrible at Excel, I had to Google this formula that will tell you the word count for a row or a column of words. So I'm just gonna label this word count, and then I'm gonna paste in this formula, but the only two things you need to update are the cell numbers in two spots. The first one is this, so A2, and then we'll put A2 over here as well. And cool, we can see 5 is our word count, and then just clicking that will expand and give you the rest of the word count for all of your keywords here. So now what I wanna do, I really don't care about anything else. I could just delete that and make this more simple to view and make this a little bit bigger for you guys there. So now what you can do at this point is head over to this column and remove the 2 and 3. And so now we're just gonna see all the keywords that have at least 4 words in it. At this point, go ahead and copy all these keywords, which we see is about 202, which yeah, you can kind of see it underneath my picture there. Copy those keywords and then bring them over into Jungle Scout, head over to your keyword list and find that keyword list that you just created. So we just created this one here. I'm gonna click more options and import this list of keywords directly into our keyword list here. So now we have about 222 keywords that we can actually sort through and prioritize based on the search volume here. So this is really powerful for us. I do see there's a keyword medium that trickled in there. I'm not sure how that happened, but we can just get rid of that here really quickly. But now what we can do is just, again, prioritize all of our top keywords based on search volume and then plug these into our advertising campaigns. Now I wanted to bring up this tip here. So we just downloaded 3 different reports, consolidated a huge list of long tail keywords, but the next step is to add those into your advertising campaigns. Personally, what I like to do is segment these keywords by selling proposition. For example, we know that our product is a washable pee pad for dog, but it's also waterproof and specifically for potty training, but it can also be used in a puppy playpen. It can be used in a whelping box, a crate liner, and then there's different types of dogs that can use it, like large and XL pets. So most likely in our keyword list, we have a bunch of different keywords that mean different things. For example, let's see, puppy pads for pet training. And then we have washable pee pads. We also have dog pee pads extra large for playpens. Okay, so what we wanna do here at this point is use this big list as a master keyword list and then create segmented list for each selling point. So I'd put all the pet training or potty training keywords in one list, all the waterproof keywords in another list and so on. And then launch those on Amazon in their own segmented list. And if you wanna see exactly how this is done, we have a YouTube video that walks through this 3-step approach to segmenting your keywords and launching them in segmented advertising campaigns. If you're on YouTube, we'll put that video for you on the screen over here. And if you're on LinkedIn, we'll put that video for you in the comment section or in the description above. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, make sure to leave a like, a comment, or a repost to your network. Thank you so much, and we'll see you in the next one.